I want to tell you what has happened here, so that you know. Let me start in, I will end up with what's happening in the Western Cape with the votes. But let me start with the main thing that you must understand. It's important I tell you this before I'm going to tell the world. Guys, if you can remember, I kept on telling you guys how popular Zuma is. If anybody can remember that, and if you think I'm lying, go back and see. I've been telling people that. I even stuck my neck out and I said he's more popular than Nelson Mandela. If you can remember that. Then I also told you that I wrote a book called Kill Zuma by Any Means Necessary. Now, why am I telling you these things? I'm telling you these things because there's a group of billionaires in this country. And now you have to listen very carefully. There's a group of billionaires in this country that hate Zuma. But they don't just hate him for him to disappear. They hate him and they want him to publicly hang for a lack of a better description. You must listen very nicely what I'm saying. They want to finish him. They want to demolish him. They want to humiliate him. Zuma left. He went to Nkandla. He was done with politics. He resigned on his own accord. Zuma resigned. Zuma resigned. One, he did two things, which is very important that you must know. Zuma resigned as the president of this country when they pushed him. Secondly, when the people in KZN said Zuma must not give himself over to the police to go to jail, he gave himself over to the police. That saved a lot of lives because people were willing to die with a standoff with the police that night. So people, I want you to follow what I'm going to say because I'm going to tell you the most important thing in this election that's about to happen now. So when Zuma resigned, it was the end of Zuma. But no, they were not happy. They were not happy. They wanted to go and get Zuma and put him in jail again. Zuma went for the same thing to jail that Koos Becker refused to appear before the commission. Long story short, what am I trying to say to you? Now, Zuma is now back. Zuma's back with a bang. Whether you like it or not, this is democracy. Some people don't like the fact that PA is back with a bang. Some people don't like that Zuma's back with a bang. Some people don't like that. Whatever you think about Gayton McKenzie, Zuma, Helen Zille, John Steenhuisen, whatever, it's democracy. People choose who they want in power. Now, here's where it gets dangerous for this country. Here it's where it gets very dangerous for South Africa. The business, once again, business wants a DA-ANC coalition. The reason why they want the DA-ANC coalition is because they don't want Zuma to be part of this government. The Zulu people, half of our army is Zulu. Half of our police force is Zulu. The Zulu people stood behind Zuma. They got 45% of the vote in KZN. I hope you guys still follow me. Now, if you're going to exclude Zuma from anything in this country, be prepared for anything. What am I saying? I'm not saying he should be excluded. He should be included. I am saying business should release the money they are all sitting with in order for children, for people to have jobs in South Africa. Part of the reason why there's joblessness is because the cash piles of business, they are stashing their cash piles. They don't want to release the money back in the economy that they make from the economy. So a lot of companies are sitting with huge stock, huge cash. When that cash gets released back, there'll be jobs for people. There's no jobs for people at the moment because they are waiting to see how many, what is the outcome of the election. So business wants the DA-ANC coalition. Business is once again interfering in something that they should not interfere in. Now, it's, you see, arrogance helps no one. We can all be arrogant and say, no, to hell with them. Listen, when the riots happened in 3 days in KZN, people died. Now, don't come here in this life with your arrogance and say, to hell with Zuma. This is not just about Zuma. We love South Africa. This is about South Africa. Now, let me tell you what has Zuma done as a plan B. In the city of Joburg and Ekurhuleni, they have 71 councillors in Etiquini. Now, this is where you should listen. In the city of Joburg, Ekurhuleni, Etiquini, they have 71 councillors that wants to join MK. You're hearing it here for the first time. Now, the deal between the ANC and the DA is based on the metros as part of it. So once they form a coalition, Zuma is going to unleash those councillors to resign. Those metros are then going to collapse, which will be the foundation of the deal between the DA and the ANC. Helen Zille and them think they have a deal. They don't know what they have. Zuma has made provision for the DA-ANC coalition. 30% of ANC guys will leave the ANC. And then Zuma will come back stronger than what he is at the moment. So my advice to every billionaire in this country, just stay the hell out of matters. And don't try to force matters to safeguard your profits or to alleviate your fears of what should happen in this country. Rather release the money so people can get jobs. Ek is die bang vir julle nie. I'm not these political leaders that you guys fund that must now say nothing, but they can see what you are doing. You are involved. You want to impose John Steenhuisen as a deputy president of this country. Do you really think 45% that Zuma got in KZN, those people will just fold their eyes, their hands? Do you think 30% of the ANC will go with the DA? You go on here, you pump. I want to expose your lie about the DA here on this life. You're underestimating Zuma. You're undermining a man that is smart. He's a chess master. So all I want, already MK came out and they said elections is not free and fair. Now this is, and patriots, are you still with me? Are you still? Zuma will come back stronger. That is, there's four parts. I'm now still at part one. What?